My research focuses on trying to actually see the light coming from Jupiter-sized exoplanets orbiting other stars. And it's extremely challenging to take a picture of an exoplanet because of this problem that we call the spotlight and the firefly. So it's as if you're staring straight down onto a spotlight and trying to see in this little tiny firefly flickering right next to it. It's an incredibly challenging contrast problem. So one of the things that we do is make sure that we have the best resolution possible, which is what we do through using adaptive optics technology that's meant to correct for the blurring effects of the atmosphere. So most people are familiar with this. As they look up in the sky, they'll see a star twinkling and moving around. And that's because the turbulence in the atmosphere and the air that you're breathing is actually bad for astronomy. It's causing the light from that star to move all around as it heads down to your telescope. So by the time it gets there, it's all blurred out. So what we do is we basically measure the turbulence in real time and correct for it using this cool technology called a deformable mirror. And this deformable mirror, we send commands to it that cause it to bend and wiggle in real time exactly in the way such that it will cancel out the blurring effects of the atmosphere and give you back your really pristine, perfect resolution image. What makes me the most excited about being a scientist, and I feel really passionate about, is just being sort of on the edge of discovery. So that little thrill you get when you're doing something very minute, like you're studying some planetary system, for instance, and you realize you're the first person to ever figure out how much carbon is in this planet. For some reason, that is just so exciting and amazing, and it's like this knowledge that wasn't there before you started looking, all of a sudden you're the first person that's ever had this knowledge. And so somehow that really motivates me and gets me really excited. And I love teaching and doing outreach to the greater community to give back basically the sense of wonder that I feel about the universe. I love to share that with students and the public as well. UC San Diego has a really great tradition of some very powerful women physicists and astronomers that it's really inspiring to be able to follow in the footsteps. People like my advisor, Andrea Ghez, or Margaret Burbage, who is a distinguished faculty here at UC San Diego, Sally Wright, all of these women made such amazing strides in a time when it was so difficult for women to do it. The physics department has actually hired three new women astrophysicists here in the past year. And I think this speaks a lot to UC San Diego's commitment to trying to increase the equity and inclusion amongst the faculty and make the faculty a more diverse population. So I'm really happy to be one of these three women. I'm very happy to come into a department where I know that this is something that they're working on. It's something that they're trying to pursue. And so I think in the future, I will be able to contribute to the increasing equity and inclusion in our physics department and hopefully the university as a whole.